your password was likely stolen by criminals. Today we look at how they did it and what you need to do to protect yourself. Hi, this is Carsten from Hacking Matters, where each week we look at best practices in hacking defense. We just learned of the largest credential theft in history. 16 billion credentials were stolen by criminals. That is 2 credentials on average for every person on Earth. Or if you are an active internet user, probably more like 4 or 5 for you. How did criminals steal 16 billion credentials? Well, they didn't do it all at once. In fact, this unfolded over many years, many smaller hacks that add together to a data set that's now available to criminals of 16 billion credentials. Many of these credentials will already be outdated, but do they show your pattern of how you usually choose passwords? In which case, you need to change that pattern. There are multiple ways for criminals to steal passwords, but one of them is larger than all the other ones combined, and that is Infostealer Malware. Viruses running on your computer that basically take a note of everything you're typing into the computer. They know which websites you go to, they know which fields you click on, where you type in a username, where you type in a password, and those sets, website, username, password, plus enriched with some other context information, are then collected. Often collected for future use, because as you're using your computer, you go to this website, you go to that website, and you're leaving interesting information with the Infostealer malware, who accumulate and accumulate and accumulate, often from tens of thousands, sometimes hundreds of thousands of infected users, to then sell parts of what they collected onto other users. Maybe someone is interested specifically in online banking or PayPal or crypto-related things. So you package all the website logins for those domains as a criminal and you sell them on. But there's all of these other credentials that are more miscellaneous, and those are then often sold in bulk or sometimes even just stolen from criminal to criminal. So somehow they leak into the wider criminal ecosystem. And if you stitch all of those together, you get into the billions. Most of this data comes from Infostealer malware. Now, some other ways, of course, are phishing. You click on a link to a fake website, you type in a password. Now they know the password that you wanted to type in to the real website. A third way are fake Android apps, where maybe through a text message, you get lured into installing an insecure app, and then you type your credentials into that. Those are the 3 ways that kind of you're responsible for in one way or another: having a virus on your computer, falling for a phishing website, or installing a fake app. Now, there's other ways that credentials get stolen that are outside of your control. For instance, if websites get hacked, often the entire database of the credentials is stolen if they're stored unencrypted, or credentials are intercepted as users enter them. So this is completely outside of your control, as is credential stuffing attacks, basically people trying different passwords for different accounts on online services. Any of these 5 ways can mean your passwords end up in this big data leak of 16 billion credentials. Next, how do you make sure that no more credentials are stolen from you? It goes without saying that you want to switch on multi-factor authentication on all your important websites. And many of them demand it. You're not going to make a bank transfer or log into a major crypto exchange without having multi-factor authentication enabled. Some websites highly encourage it, and you should switch it on wherever your important data is stored. But as an internet user, you're using 100, maybe 200 different web properties. Are you really going to have MFA for all of them? Where possible, log in with a secure account, SSO from Google or Apple or Microsoft. But that still leaves some websites kind of these 1-time, 2 times per year usage where you don't want to have to go through full account recovery just because you lost your MFA phone. So password leakage is a problem and will remain a problem for some time, even if you switch on MFA for all the accounts that you consider important. A little later in the video, we'll also look at how hackers can get around MFA and hack your account even if you have switched it on. If Infostealer malware is the biggest culprit, then your main defense needs to be on the endpoint, making sure you're not installing viruses. And of course, a good EDR system, endpoint detection and response, basically an evolved virus scanner, is your best line of defense. And these are pretty good at detecting most of the malware spreading around. Now, don't trust this blindly, but definitely have a good EDR installed on your machine. Second, make sure that you run downloads that could include viruses through a website like VirusTotal. So whenever you want to install a new piece of software, you download it from somewhere on the internet, run it through VirusTotal, which is basically a collection of more than 50 virus scanners, and they all run at the same time on what you uploaded. And if none of them thinks it's a virus, there's a good chance it really isn't, and you can safely install that software. Third, specifically for Android users, only install apps through Google Play. Don't allow any other application to install new software. On an iPhone, for instance, that's already enforced, you have to use the Apple Store. So stick with that same security boundary on your Android device. Should go without saying, but we have so many cases of people still installing apps because some urgent message arrives that prompts action, leading to a huge scam industry. We had a recent video on that. All right, that's how you prevent your new passwords from being stolen in the future. But what do you do about the passwords that were already stolen? First, you want to find out which passwords were stolen. And if you don't happen to have this database yourself, go to a website like Have I Been Pwned. They have the data in the background and allow you to check for just your own entries so you can then go fix those passwords. Make sure you do this regularly. It's tied into certain accounts too. If you store your passwords in Firefox, for instance, Firefox will warn you. If you store them in Google, Google will warn you. But of course, for your most important passwords, you don't want to store them in Firefox or Google's account. You want to store them in a password manager. And that's the next advice. As you're changing your passwords, make sure it is in a password manager using an auto-generator that is a very long password. You'll never be able to remember it. But the advantage is that it will also be a different password for each website so that if for whatever reason one website loses all of their passwords, only that one website for you is affected and not all the other accounts. It looks like our accounts are increasingly well protected between MFA, EDR, using VirusTotal, using a password manager, not installing unknown apps. It leaves relatively little wiggle room for criminals to steal useful passwords from you. Now, do they continue trying though? Well, they're slightly pivoting. Criminals are acknowledging that your passwords are less and less useful and acknowledge that by upping the game in two ways. They phish for your MFA tokens and they steal your cookies. MFA phishing, as easy as it sounds, instead of asking someone for just a username and a password, it also asks you for your MFA token. And unless it's a hardware type one, like a YubiKey or a passkey, you're just letting a criminal access your account. So that's the phishing route. Now, the dominant form of stealing passwords, though, is Infostealer malware. So not phishing. It doesn't present a fake website to you. It steals from the real website, and those passwords become less useful. But that's where cookie stealing comes in. A cookie is what your browser remembers after logging into a website that makes sure that you don't have to keep logging in with every click you're doing. A cookie can be valid anywhere from minutes to months. Minutes, that would be more an online banking session. Months are websites that you log in once and you continue to stay logged in. Even for critical accounts, like your email, cookies stay valid for weeks, if not months. So there's this window of opportunity where the Infostealer malware steals not just your password when you log in, but also that cookie after you log in. And criminals can use that cookie for a long period of time to mess with your account. So we see increased activity of criminals trading these cookies, acknowledging that passwords are less useful, but also staying in the game of breaking into your account and getting use out of it. This underlines once again the importance of endpoint protection. Make sure you're clicking on as few things as possible, run everything through VirusTotal, and have a good EDR system. Most companies have these EDRs deployed. Most home users don't, but now in a world from work from home, where everyone uses their corporate properties from their home computers, at least once in a while, the line really blurs. And we need to make sure that we have good EDR on all the different systems that our users interact with. Now, even EDR is not unfailable. We have a whole video on how to evade EDR, but every little bit helps in preventing criminals from collecting the next 16 billion credentials. I hope this was helpful. If it was, please show it with a like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next week. Happy hacking. You